You've seen art. You're familiar with art. You've read about art pieces being sold for millions of dollars, and you've heard stories behind art pieces. But have you really seen art? Have you really seen the cold haze lit up by the sunrise in Monet's Charing Cross Bridge? Have you really felt the unbearable silence of God in the Rothko Chapel? Or was it just on a digital screen? Nowadays, digital media offers a seemingly convenient way for the public to see art, without the hustle of traveling to a gallery or even buying a ticket. Lying on a sofa, one can skim through all of the world-famous paintings on their tablet or smartphone in one Sunday afternoon. The convenience has created what seems like an easy way out, an easy way to get a basic understanding of what famous pieces of art look like, or an easy way to be able to bring up stories behind art pieces at parties. Is this really equivalent to seeing the paintings in the galleries though? Maybe we can zoom closer and even closer, but is it enough? We've all seen plenty of photos of sunrises on Instagram, but are any of those actually comparable to seeing the little orange circle rising from the horizon, warming the blue to a radiant gold? Art is the same way. For example, Jackson Pollock's paintings might seem like a mess made by exploding paint cans, but layers and layers of colors exist underneath the seemingly messy surface. The details of paintings made decades ago are simply not meant to be viewed through a digital device. Additionally, the gallery experience is not just about the paintings. Curation often plays a larger role than recognized. For example, Rothko deliberatively requires the galleries to show his pieces in sets in an individual area, creating a space surrounded by his paintings. Contemporary artist Maurizio Catalan displays his art piece, a fully golden and fully functional toilet, in one of the washrooms of the Marian Goodman Gallery, adding a layer of surprise to the piece. These thoughtful curations are the behind-the-scenes details that digital media simply cannot carry through. An art gallery is a place where you can view the world through the creative and sensitive eyes of artists, a place where you can reflect and reason with your worldviews, but often a place that is neglected and overlooked since more and more people begin to think they can just look at art through their smartphones. There are art galleries in most major cities around the world, including Toronto. So next time, if you have the chance, visit one and really experience it, and you won't regret it.